State Bank of India has signed a pact with the Bank of China to boost business opportunities. SBI signed an MoU to enhance business synergies between both the banks. The Indian and Myanmar armies have, in a coordinated operation, destroyed at least 10 camps belonging to an insurgent group in Myanmar, which had become a threat to India's mega Kaladan project in the neighboring country. Export-Import Bank of India, Exim Bank, signed a loan agreement on behalf of the government of US$83.11 million to Congo for financing 3 solar power projects in the Central African country. Hindi writer Leeladhar Jagudi honored with Vyas Samman 2018 for his collection of poems, Jitne Log Utne Prem. He was awarded Padma Shri in 2004 apart from other awards, including Sahitya Akademi Award, Akashwani National Award and Uttarakhand Gaurav Samman. Bumphead parrotfish, Bulbomatopan maricatum, is an important component of coral reef ecosystem, but is highly endangered globally. It is categorized as vulnerable in the Red List of the International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN. In a first-of-its-kind bust, the Delhi police inducted a mobile command and control vehicles, MCCV, with all modern equipment into service. British Prime Minister Theresa May welcomed the EU decision to postpone Brexit beyond the 29th of March. The UK will be offered a delay until the 22nd of May, if MPs approve the withdrawal deal negotiated with the EU next week. In order to reduce the burden for the electric vehicle users who hunt for charging stations in the city, electric vehicles charging stations has been planned to be established in Bengaluru, Andhra Pradesh. World Health Organization experts said it would be irresponsible for any scientist to conduct human gene editing studies in people, and a central registry of research plans should be set up to ensure transparency. Naomi Jahangir Rao, a prominent Indian-American lawyer, has been sworn in as U.S. Circuit Judge for the District of Columbia Circuit Court of Appeals. Japan-based Daiichi Aluminium Industry Co. Ltd., through its Indian subsidiary, is to set up an aluminium alloy plant at Sri City in Andhra Pradesh. Daiichi Aluminium Industry India Pvt. Ltd. would make an initial investment of 250 crore rupees. Reserve Bank of India, RBI, Governor Shaktikanta Das called for permanent status to Finance Commission. RBI Governor Shaktikanta Das is also the member of the 15th Finance Commission. Star javelin thrower Neeraj Chopra was named to lead a 39-member Indian athletics team for next month's Asian Championships in Doha, with sprint sensation Hima Das also making the cut in 400 meters despite her recent below-par show. State Bank